Once you have developed a clear understanding of the customer segment and their specific problem, you will start to think about the solution that you are going to offer to those customers. The solution should be suitable to meet the key pain points or customer needs that you have identified during the problem interviews. Lean Startup proposes that you are not going to develop the entire product or service first and then try to market it, but that you need to, at a very early stage, get a feeling for whether your customers would actually adopt your product. Imagine what happens if you don't. Webvan was an online grocery business that had plans to expand to the whole US. After its IPO in 1999, it was valued at $4.8 billion. In 2001, Webvan filed for bankruptcy, losing more than $800 million and firing 2,000 employees. What happened? Webvan was stuck on the mantra of get big fast. They invested heavily in infrastructure and technology such as warehouses and logistics technology. But customers did not accept their service. Revenues were far below expectations. Another e-commerce entrepreneur had a better idea. The founder of Zappos was setting out to create a web shop for shoes. What seems normal today was not explored in the late 90s. But instead of building warehouses and investing in inventory, the Zappos founder went to shoe stores, took pictures of shoes, and put them online. When an order came in, he went to the store, bought the pair, and shipped it. From a lean startup perspective, he was testing the hypothesis, people will buy shoes online with the least effort possible. After he found support for this hypothesis, Zappos was able to scale and was sold to Amazon for $1.2 billion in 2009. What the founder of Zappos was doing was to develop a minimum viable product. An MVP is the prototype with a minimum feature set to address the right set of problems. With the main goal not to sell at scale, but to receive customer feedback on your proposed solution. We distinguish between example MVP and real-world MVP, depending on whether customers' problems are already being solved. A landing page is a web page which serves as the entry point for a website or a particular section of a website. A good landing page explains the product offer in a clear manner and places visual emphasis on the value of the product or service presented. You can use a landing page to collect contact information of potentially interested users and assess conversion rates, i.e. from those who looked at the page to those that signed up for more information, and to A/B test different configurations of your solution. The logic behind landing pages such as MVP is that if you can't get potential customers to sign up for more information, it's very unlikely that they will turn into paying customers. Landing pages can be built and hosted easily with existing web services. A video MVP is a video that explains how a product or service may work. A famous example of a video MVP is a Dropbox video, where the founding team mimicked the functionality of rapid file sharing across platforms without having the particular technology in place. This video raised a lot of interest from the community of potential adopters. A wireframe is a schematic design of a web page or app, which represents the basic functionality of the software and gives the users an idea about the look and feel. For constructing wireframes, you can also use web services or engage in paper prototyping. The second group of MVP are those where the customer receives more than just information, but also a real solution to the problem. We distinguish Wizard of Oz MVP and Concierge MVP. In a Wizard of Oz MVP, the customer is not aware of the fact that the solution is not yet delivered by technology, but rather by human effort. The Zappos case is a good example of a Wizard of Oz MVP. An example of a concierge MVP was the creation of Airbnb. Here, the founders set up a simple website to let people stay at their apartment during a conference event. Three people used this service, hence giving a first support for the initial hypothesis of whether people would like to stay at other people's places. In a concierge MVP, the user is aware of the fact that the solution is delivered by humans. Here, the entrepreneur is closely following his or her customers through the experience. The benefits are that you establish a close connection to your customers, who will provide you with rich information on how they are using and reacting to your product. Another benefit is that you can very quickly adapt the user experience and hence shorten test cycles. You should use your MVP as an instrument to learn more about whether the proposed solution that you offer is actually one that is of relevance for the customer. Hence, while some MVP also give you quantitative data, MVP are a tool that you should use in qualitative market research, such as in observations and interviews. For example, your MVP can be used in the context of a problem interview to elicit customer response. What if we had a solution that did X? What would make you most excited? We are looking to sign up test customers when the solution is ready. Would you be part of the club? We are shipping a solution for €100 when the product is ready. Should we sign you up? You can use the problem interviews for confirmatory hypothesis testing. For example, 8 out of 10 respondents will be excited about feature X. In the end, the solution interviews should give you a good indication if, and if so, with which type of solution you want to continue to develop your business.